And the Arbiter's grounds, or the Arbiter's temple, kind of just, at this point, at least to me, kind of hits the low point. The Arbiter's grounds in general isn't too terrible past this point, but it gets really streamlined, is the word. Well, not really streamlined, just becomes more one pathway and then hit end of dungeon. I'm going the wrong way. I need to pull that up. There. Let's pull this thing, even though there's logically no place to hold on to that and pull it. Yeah. Whatever, Link. Do what you do. Let's keep pulling that. Do we go up to this part of the floor? I don't. Yes. Yes, we do. Good. We found it, guys. We found the place we need to go to. Because there is a chest here that will have a key that we can use to enter the next part of the dungeon, so that way we can get the item, and that way we can make do with this game and move on. And to be honest, they could have done better. Let's get down there and move along with our lives. Good, we're at the bottom. There is a door. Need that key for this one room. And this one room has... not only does it have the invisible rats, it also has spike traps, which we will see, like, right there. And there. And it is quite literally the worst thing ever. Because it is painful on so many levels. We want to go this way. Bypass all of this nonsense. Which... Trilling, walk in the sand. That is a wall of spikes. We got ourselves the wonderful rats, which won't come off us at all, so wolf form it is. Go away. Nobody wants you crazy rats. I certainly don't. I gotta go up this way. Leave me alone. Spike wall, so I gotta go all this way around, and there is probably a redead over here. Yes, there is. Hi, I'm gonna gnaw on the back of your skull. No! My turn! Go away. Okay, so is that all I needed? Yes, it is. Okay, now we're gonna pull on that lever. Go away! Frickin' things seem like they're frickin' infinite spawning, and I hate that so much. Basically, pull this thing over. My Wii is now lopsided. And it's not a good thing. Once we get past this part, I'm gonna fix that. There we go. I'm just gonna appear. In case people are wondering, Uku's around here, so you can pick her up here if you need to. Which we're going to, because, requirements. Hi there.
Free at last! Gracious, you have a nice fellow who helped me out the other day. How nice to see you again. Well, now that we found each other, let's stick together for a bit longer, huh? I'll be alright with you, so if you want to warp out, just let me know.
That's better. I fixed my Wii. We're good. Since I'm playing the GameCube version, yeah, I'm playing off the Wii. What about it? What are you gonna do? Where am I going? I am going this way. Even though I'm probably going the wrong way, and I don't care. There are stealthos here. I want... not what I wanted. I want this. I want that. Hi. Oh, this is gonna be good. Hi, my name is Link. Welcome to Jackass.
Okay, now that's getting pretty freaking old. I should stop doing that. Right, I went the right way. Okay, good. Right. This temple. How to say? Sand. Lots of sand. And the sand, not my favorite thing about this temple, but hey, it's not terrible. It's okay. I like it. Not my favorite place in the whole world, but hey, I'll deal with it. Because I kind of have to. As it is a part of the game. And dealing with it is something I must do. Now, logically, you'd think Link wouldn't do this. But if we don't cut it, we can't move on. You'd think Link wouldn't be a complete moron to cut that when there are so many different spiritual tags on it to not, like, you know, don't touch this. It's cursed, basically. And you would think Link wouldn't do that, but unfortunately, he had to. Same deal with the pose. It'll be invisible for the first part, up till now, where it's now visible. And we now have to fight it as Link! Not Wolf Link, but regular Link. And I'll take my arrows over my bombs. The music this guy has is pretty ballin'. But you can't really get a good eye on this guy, which kind of sucks. I was sort of waiting for him to do that. I guess I was just not shooting him. I literally don't think the moral draw has any effect on bosses or mini bosses at all. But shoot him once, he'll go circle around you, end up on the floor, or you can literally just wail on him. To be honest, I don't even know what this guy's name is, and since Mina doesn't tell you the names of any foe, you can't actually find out his name. In-game. Not through looking through the game's code. But, again, like most mini-bosses, he's kind of pathetic. He's definitely some kind of demon, but who could just escape through the hole in the ceiling. Okay, why would you leave a hole in the ceiling for the monster to escape? No, I'm legit curious. Why would they do that? That makes zero sense. You should not ever do that, ever. Why? As Getsu called it, the Beyblade. So, yeah. We have a top. Basically a top. And, let me tell you this. After this dungeon, completely useless. Except for, like, once or twice in two other dungeons. And that's it. Otherwise, it's completely useless at this point. And it will not be missed. They could have done so much more with this. They really could have. But they don't. That's the consequence when you design games with gameplay first. You kind of forget to put important things in there and remember to use them. Like the spinner. You put this really neat item in here, but you kind of forget you have it. Right, around here there is a piece of heart chest, which we're gonna get. So, onward. I think this is it. Probably not, but it probably is. It is. Alright, so we got another piece of heart, which works out fabulously for me, so now I can get the heck out of dodge. Please don't hit me. Thank you. Where am I going? Going that way. And then that way. And then into here, which will make no sense for me at all, which just really annoys me. Oh. Oh. So that's how you do that. Well, never mind. That didn't turn out as bad as I thought it would, because normally that turns out very frickin' bad, and I'm in there for like a minute. Hi, you're gonna be trapped here, so I really don't care about you. Spinner, get me out of here. Up we go, and now I gotta go even further along this way. No! Why? Why dost thou forsake me, game? And if you look, I kinda just stuck there. I kinda can't do squat. So, I'm gonna do the mercy kill. And, hi. Goodbye. They're kind of just, they were just there. The poor things. They didn't even know what hit them. I guess they kind of do. It kind of exploded in their face, but, regardless. Not what I'm trying to do. I am very bad at this. I should probably want to go this way. Oop. Again, I am very bad at this. Let's just keep that in mind. Mainly because the spinner is so underused, you never really get much practice with it. No, why? Why dost thou forsake me from getting higher? It's literally just moments away from the boss room. I just want to get there. Aha! Thank you! Just what I wanted. And quite literally, that is it. That dungeon was so short, it was shorter than the Forest Temple. And that was the first dungeon. That says a lot. To be honest, that says a lot about this game. No, we go here. We're spinning. We're doing what a top does best in spin. To be quite honest, this got very annoying. And you have to rapidly press the A button until this scene comes along. Oh, the top. The spinning top. I might as well just make a dreidel song at this rate. Since that's kind of what we're doing here. But since I kind of really don't care about this whole segment, we're just going to watch Link surf on a top. Link is surfing on a top. Let it sink in for a moment. Surfing on a top. And quite literally, I have no idea where I'm going. This way. That didn't work. Not working. We're gonna die in the sand, aren't we? Probably. We're gonna die in the sand. This is pleasant. Watch him drown in the sand, ladies. As he just drowns in the sand. The poor blonde bastard. Didn't know what happened to him at all. That was a rupee, which I don't need, so I'm not gonna bother getting that. So, let's just go up this way. I need to land on that platform, and this is literally the most awkward camera angle in the entire frickin' world. There we go. A perfect fit. Even though technically we were moving, so I don't think that would fit in as well. Never mind. It really doesn't matter, does it? Not really. And again, this is just a thing that happens with this game. Kinda. I guess. But we're reaching the boss room now, so this is the sign where I should stop the video. I probably should, actually. No fairy? Okay, that works. Next time on Let's Replay The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, we're gonna fight the boss. And then plot. Lots and lots of plot. See you all next time.